Hi, Danica here, and I design WordPress membership sites. In this series of videos, we will be working on LearnDash LMS. So I have my local WordPress environment in here. And if we check out all of the active plugins that we only have LearnDash Hub, LearnDash LMS, and LearnDash LMS Pro Panel. Now, to minimize the confusion, I'm gonna deactivate the Pro Panel for now so that we could tackle each of the section one by one. The goal of this series of videos is to understand how LearnDash works from beginner's level, and there may be new features in here that even I haven't used yet, but we're gonna go over with those together and we're gonna test it out. I'm also gonna be using my usual process whenever I have a LearnDash project, so I may share some tips and tricks for LearnDash. In this local environment, we don't have any additional page builder in here, so we will be using the default Gutenberg page builder by WordPress. And of course, in terms of themes, we will be using the 2022. So everything's a default. That means if you have this kind of setup, you are only paying for your hosting, domain, and of course, LearnDash LMS to set up your website. So first, before we dive through, I'm gonna talk about the two, LearnDash Hub and LearnDash LMS. So LearnDash Hub, it helps you manage the add-ons that's available or that's provided by LearnDash and other third-party software. Before, this was not actually included, but I think maybe they have added this to manage this additional add-ons properly than before. They also have two tabs in here, so LearnDash and then third-party, which opens to a new tab with a list of LearnDash from the plugins directory. So that's LearnDash Hub. Also, LearnDash Hub is a section where you can be licensing your plugin so that you get the updates, latest updates that LearnDash release. But in terms of updates, I recommend you wait for 1 week before you actually update your plugins, whatever that is in WordPress, because most of the time when there is a new version of a plugin, this company will be working on fixing the bugs that may come up in their latest version. So I recommend you wait for a minimum of a week before you update your plugin. So there's a two tabs under LearnDash Hub settings, visibility and again license, which we have gone over. In the visibility section, it says here, add team members. By default, these plugins only allow the admin who authenticated with LearnDash to access. You can allow other admins by adding them here. So this section, what it means is the LearnDash Hub section, it's only visible to the admins, but you could also allow other admins to access the section if you add them in here. Basically, that's what it means. I haven't really tried this yet. Maybe I think the usage of this is to not include this section, especially if you're using their grouping functionality. Again, personally, I haven't tested this visibility section yet at the time of this recording. So if we start with LearnDash LMS, there is an overview video with some video from LearnDash directly. They also have additional resources, getting started guide, and so on. So you will have actually all of the tutorials that you may need, but let's just check the videos and what's the date of it. So it's actually in year 2019. Maybe some of their videos are older, so they may be working on a newer version. You may want to check out their channel for any latest tutorials that they may have added. But you could see all of the stuff in here. So when I was new to LearnDash, I actually watched all of these videos. So I highly suggest you check that as well. But again, some of these are older ones, so there may be new features or layout that may have changed in compared to the time that they have recorded their videos in here. Again, links like tips and tricks, any news from them, support, and so on. You could find all of that in here. On the left side, so if we this section, this is LearnDash. So they have overview, courses, lessons, topics. So these are actually the three like main content that LearnDash holds for you. Courses is the highest one, and of course lessons and belongs to a course, and topics belongs to a lessons. They have quizzes, questions, certificates, and groups. Quizzes, you need to set up some questions before you could create one. And certificates could be assigned to courses. So when they finish some course, we could generate some certificate. For the groups, we could create a group, and we could actually use groups in terms of acting it as a membership for your website. So example, if you have three groups, or let's just say two for simplicity, one is paid, one is free. And if I'm a member of the paid group, and that group has like two courses that belongs to it, then that means I get to access those two groups. But the other free members, which is part is also of the other groups, won't get to see those courses because they are not a member of the paid group. We're gonna tackle this more in detail, so don't worry. On the third section, they have challenge, exams, assignments, reports, and settings. Challenge exam in the description from LearnDash is it's a way for allowing your members to skip some requirements if they finish this exam, if I'm not mistaken. Haven't used this that much, but we will be checking it very in detail to see how it really works and maybe how you could take advantage of this functionality. And then we have some assignments. Usually these are like an essays and format. And then we have some reports and then settings. For the reports, if we open this, we could export some users' reports, and there's also some transaction tab. And of course, LearnDash settings, they have different tabs in here. At the time of this recording, they have general registration, payments, emails, translation, support, and advanced. If I click support, it is giving me all the data like LearnDash version, license if it's valid, database version, and so on. So maybe if you are like having problem with LearnDash for your website, you may want to download this and provide this with the support if they request for it. For the advanced, there is some bulk editing, importing and exporting, custom labels, and so on. We're gonna go over this one by one. So thanks for watching, and we're gonna start with the courses, and I will see you on that video.